गुड मॉर्निंग ट्वेल्थ स्टूडेंट्स, लेसन नंबर 3 इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री। नेक्स्ट अवर लेक्चर इज पार्ट 9। अवर टॉपिक इज पेज नंबर 85, 3.5 इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल्स एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस। सो फॉर न्यू टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस सेल्स एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस। अवर पार्ट इज पार्ट 9। नाउ इन एन इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल्स एक्सटर्नल सोर्सेज आर वोल्टेज इज यूज टू ब्रिंग अबाउट अ केमिकल रिएक्शन। ओके, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट अवर केमिकल रिएक्शन सो वी हैव टू गिव अ वोल्टेज। इम्पॉर्टेंस, सो वॉट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस? इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंस इन लैब एंड केमिकल इंडस्ट्रीज। वन ऑफ सिंपलेस्ट इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू कॉपर स्ट्रिप्स डिपिंग इन एक्वियस सॉल्यूशन ऑफ CuSO4। ओके, सी दिस इज CuSO4 सॉल्यूशन एंड टू स्ट्रिप्स ऑफ कॉपर, वन इज एनोड एंड वन इज कैथोड। नाउ DC वोल्टेज अप्लाइड टू टू इलेक्ट्रोड्स, देन Cu+2 आयन्स डिस्चार्ज एट कैथोड नेगेटिवली चार्ज्ड। सो फ्रॉम कॉपर सल्फेट Cu+2 + 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन Cu, दिस इक्वेशन इज कॉल्ड 3.28। नाउ कॉपर मेटल इज डिपॉजिटेड ऑन द कैथोड। नाउ एट एनोड कॉपर इज कन्वर्टेड इंटू Cu+2 आयन्स। सो Cu+2 + 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, दिस इक्वेशन इज 3.29 3.28 and 3.29। Thus copper is dissolved, okay, oxidized at anode and deposited, yani means reduced, at cathode. In short, I am teaching you, this is basis for an industrial process in which impure copper is converted into copper of high purity. Okay, so they are making cathode and anode. Of the impure copper is made an anode that dissolves on passing current, and pure copper is deposited and cathode. Okay, so impure anode, pure it is going to convert into cathode. Now in the chemical industry, many metals like sodium, magnesium, aluminium are produced on large scale by electrochemical reduction of their respective cations. So what is the definition of electrolytic cells, how it is used and how it is important to make a pure metals? Now our next topic is quantitative aspects of electrolysis. Now one scientist, Michael Faraday, was the first scientist who described the quantitative aspects of electrolysis. Now Faraday's laws also flow from what has been discussed earlier. Okay, I am now reading Faraday's laws of electrolysis. First, after his extensive investigations of electrolysis of solutions and metals of electrolytes, Faraday published his result during 1833-34 in the form of following well-known Faraday's two laws of electrolysis. Now first, see, earlier I taught you how from impure to pure metals are converting. Now Faraday's laws, first law, the amount of chemical reaction which occurs at any electrode during electrolysis, this process is electrolysis, by a current. If we are applying a current, the current is going to pass and then the conversion of anion and cation. By a current is proportional in the quantity of electricity passed through the electrolyte solution of melt. So the amount of chemical reaction, okay, which occurs at any electrode during electrolysis by a current, we are passing a current I, is proportional. I is proportional to the quantity of electricity passed through the electrolyte. Okay, passed Now second la, the amount of different substances liberated by the same quantity of electricity. Okay, the amount of different substances liberated by, see, from impure to pure, how many grams we are, or how many moles of pure metal we are getting, it depends upon the amount, it depends upon the same quantity of electricity passing through the electrolytic solutions are proportional to their chemical equivalent weights, atomic masses of metals plus number of electrons required to reduce the cation. So these were the two laws of Faraday's law. Now I am explaining it more clearly by giving this relation. Okay, now Faraday's laws. During Faraday's time there was no constant current sources, okay, in that century. Now he was to put calorimeter, a standard, this is called calorimeter, is called standard electrolytic cells. For what? For determining the quantity of electricity passed from the amount of metals deposited or consumed. Okay, see, from this impure it is consumed, and for pure it is deposited. So it is deposited and it is consumed. So how many grams of metal from impure to pure consumed and deposited depends on, he used for determining the quantity of electricity passed for the amount of. So this apparatus is used for determining the quantity of electricity. He passed the electricity. One has to pass the electricity through this, you are knowing. Okay, so by means of this calorimeter. Now calorimeter are now obsolete, gum ho gaye hain, and we now have constant current I sources available, and the quantity of electricity Q passed is given by the relation Q is equal to IT. Q is in coulombs, I is in ampere, T is in seconds. How many times we are passing? See, current is passing. So Q is in coulomb. The quantity of electricity Q passes is given by this relation. Okay, Q, how many times we are supplying, see, current we are supplying for how many times, if we are giving 10 seconds, 10 minutes or what. Okay, this is the relation. Now the amount of electricity or charge required for oxidation or reduction depends on, see, we are taking Ag. Ag plus 1, plus 1 electron used, Ag 3.30, this is the equation I taught you. Then charge of 1 electron is equal to 1.602 into 10 raised to minus 19 C. You are knowing 1 mole of electron is, now we have to find the 1 mole of. So it is multiplied by Avogadro number. Avogadro number is 6.023 into 10 raised to 23. This is multiplied by this. So C is this value per mole. Now the quantity of electricity is called in Faradays and symbol by F. 1 Faraday is equal to 96 round about 4879650 C per mole. So we derived the value of 1 Faraday is equal to this by means of this, from the charge of electron, by this equation for 1 electron I am saying. Okay, now for second, for electron reaction, for the second Mg plus 2 plus 2 electron Mg, if we are getting, this is equation 3.31, Al plus 3 plus 3 electron Al, so 3.32. Now Mg plus 2 required 2 moles of electron, means 2 Faraday. Al plus 3, 3 moles of electron, 3 Faraday. The charge passed of current in amperes, time is in seconds. In commercial production of metals, current is as high as 50,000 amperes are used for amounts to about 0.158 Faraday per second. Okay, so I taught you how Q is equal to IT. For 1 Faraday This is for 1 Faraday, for 2 Faraday and 3 Faraday and up to this. Okay, now we are solving our example 3.10 solution. See, a solution of copper sulfate is electrolyzed for 10 minutes with a current of 1.5 amperes. What is the mass of copper deposited at the cathode? So from impure to pure copper means of copper sulfate. So now you are knowing the relation Q is equal to IT, applying that T is equal to 10 minutes, convert 10 minutes into seconds. So T is equal to 600 seconds. Charge is equal to current, charge is equal to current into time. So current is given 1.5 ampere, time is 600 seconds is equal to 1.5 ampere multiplied by 600. So you are getting 900 C. Okay, according to the reaction you are knowing Cu plus 2 copper sulfate, Cu plus 2 C. Copper sulfate Cu plus 2 plus SO4 minus 2. So Cu plus 2 plus 2 electron gives copper pure. Okay, so 2 electrons are used, means 2 Faraday are 2. So you are knowing the Faraday's value 96487. Here we derived 2 multiplied by Faraday deposited 1 mole of. See, this I calculated for 1 mole. Okay, so 1 mole means 63 grams of copper, copper's atomic weight. So for 900 C, the mass of copper deposited, see, for 2 Faraday to deposit 1 mole is equal to 63 grams, 900 C, the mass of copper, so 1 mole multiplied by 900 C, which we derived here. Okay, so 1 mole is multiplied by 900 C divided by 2 Faraday, 2 into this Faraday, so you are getting this grams, means this gram of copper is deposited at the cathode. Okay, so today I taught you our this topic, electrolytic cells and electrolysis. Up to this example I taught you example 3.12. In next lecture I will teach you 3.51, products of electrolysis. Okay students.